Agro.
Hi everyone, I'm Andreas from iGrow. iGrow is a platform for people who want to do plantation with limitation of land, knowledge of planting, and skill to harvest. We have a big problem about food security now. Crop demand will always increase. Between 2005 to 2015, crop demand increased by 100%, but agriculture yields only improved by 30%. And 70% of world population will live in urban area. That means we are very limited of the crops, so we must do more plantation. But when we do plantation, there are so many problems. Some people only have money, some people only have land, and some people only have skill. So why don't we bring them together with iGrow, a green platform by maximizing the potential of idle land in agriculture. There is four small steps in our system. You can choose the seed, you can choose the land that you want to plant the seed, and then you can fund the plantation. After that, you can communicate and control the farmers. And when the harvest time, you can get the provisionally from it. This is our role. There are sponsors who have responsible in funding the plantation. Operator as a local farmers, they must plan and maintain the plantation, and land owner who have the land. And we as a controller and supervisor of all plantation activity. This is our revenue stream. Now we have revenue stream from plantation cows, the lease of our land, agriculture product like feed or seed or fertilizer, and then we get profit sharing from each crop selling. And in ongoing run, in long run, we can get revenue from agrotourism when we manage a lot of farmland. And we can also build business in food processing. We estimate that one sponsor can bring $600. So by inviting only 10,000 sponsors, we can get $6 million each year. We have risk management scheme for total loss protection. When we get damage from disaster or crop failure, we can cover that. Material fund protection for stabilizing the crop result. In Indonesia alone, there are 31 million hectares idle land that's suitable and available for plantation in agriculture. If we can cover only 0.1% of that size, we can get annual revenue by $500 million each year. In only 3 months after we launch, we have get revenue $63,000 from 3,000 plantation in 15 hectare land. We will expand our market in B2B and B2C scheme. In B2B, we have agreed and partner with Kacang Garuda and Bulog Kelinci, the biggest peanut producers in Indonesia. And we are dealing with Semen Indonesia, Krakatau Steel and Muhammadiyah for managing their thousands of hectares their land in Java. And in B2C, there are 30 million people who have middle-up income and very concerned about green environment. This is our team. Our CEO have more than 10 years in agriculture industry, manage more than 600 hectares in Blitar. Me as CTO have made so many IT products that used by millions user, and Aditya as CBDO, MBA graduate that have expertise in risk management in agriculture area. We want to raise $3 million to operate our system, to expand our market and land acquisition. This is our website. You can see the agriculture statistic, carbon dioxide reduced estimation, and our farmland, the map of our farmland, sponsor, operator, and etc. This is our land farm. You can see how we plant the tree. This is our seeds. This is our plantation. So iGrow will bring a big impact to our society. This is an impacting investment. You can see that it will bring wealth to local farmers. It's also greening our environment. It also will utilize the idle land. So please join with us as a sponsor who fund the plantation, as an operator who can plant the plantation, and as a land owner, if you have idle land, to become the agricultural land that productive. Thank you very much.
Alright judges, your 5 minutes to ask questions to iGrow.
First of all, congratulations both of you and your entire team for spending your life doing social impact. Excellent.
Thank you very much.
How will you bring this awareness? You've got a very small community right now who knows about iGrow. How will you grow the awareness of iGrow?
Yeah, thank you very much. For bringing the awareness to the public, is we are doing the digital marketing, I mean digital campaign to the website. We built a very good website, and also we built like a small video, I mean, to increase the awareness. And also we try to win the B2B market, which is like we are, maybe we can get the, I mean, the staff, I mean, maybe the staff who are interested in investing with us. So just the way like that. And also the CSR program by the, to the company.
Yeah. I understand the incentive for the landowners. I understand the incentive for the operators. So what exactly do you think will be like the incentive for the sponsors? Is it like financially attractive, or is it more like a non-profit angle? What's the incentive there?
The incentive for sponsor is the profit sharing. When they got, like we sell the crop products and we get the revenue, they will get 40% of the like the total revenue that they will, total profit that they will get. 40% for the sponsor, 40% for the farmers, and 20% for iGrow as the manager for this.
Do you have an example that you can project with what would be a realistic scenario? How much would be in that for me?
Let's say that we harvest like a durian. Let's say for durian, for the seed itself, 5 million. We are not, in rupiah, 5 million rupiah. So basically, like if you want to join with us, so the minimum seeds is just only one seed. So you can join with us. So with one seed, the revenue that you will get is in 5 years, because of the length of the period of durian is 5 years. So after 5 years, you will get the revenue. But the length time for durian itself, they can grow until 20 years. So until 20 years, you will get the revenue. Moreover, for the selling of the
So in other words, because you're still quite new, no one's gotten their money back yet. So everyone's invested, but they're waiting for the fruits to grow in 5 to 20 years later.
Okay. Yeah, because like we have two schemes actually at the moment.
Well, what's the typical profile of the people who actually sponsor, who give you guys money?
Well, as we mentioned before, we have two typicals, model. I mean, we have two strategies. For the B2B, of course, the company itself. But for the B2C, it's like the people who are aware about the green issues. So basically, they are not just only planting the trees, but they get the revenue for planting the trees. It's not only about responsible to the environment, but getting the revenue from the being social environment.
What do you think, Stefan? Do you think that there's the limiting factor in this ecosystem would be more the sponsors?
Yeah, for me, for myself, it's like 20 years seems to me a very long time locking up my money. If I get a baby now, 20 years,
yeah.
It's a big problem.
Yeah, that's a good question actually. But we have two different schemes. The first scheme is for long run. I mean, like this is we use different seed. The first seed is like durian, which just takes like 5 years to get the revenue. But we have peanut as well. So for peanuts itself, we will get the crop revenue by 6 months. So that we works with the
I can go on iGrow now and I can be a peanut farmer. I can fund a peanut.
Yeah, of course, yes, of course. But it's different scheme. With peanuts, this is not one seed, but it's very hard to calculate one seed, of course, for peanuts. But what we get is like per hectare. So like you can be a farmer of peanuts by using a hectare calculation with us.
Oh, how if you fail to harvest the
We have two scheme, two different schemes for risk management. The first one is by insurance scheme. So they will protect you against the like unpredictable events such as like disaster or flood or fire or something. So basically, when the disaster happen, it will cover by insurance. It's not 100%, but it's at least it reduces your risk by 80%.
So can I choose like peanut? The return will be 6%. Durian, the return will be 20% per year. How does it work? How do you communicate this to the investor?
For peanut, maybe we can do it to plant the peanut for only 14 million rupiah for 1 hectare. But you can buy only 0.1 hectare for 1.5 million rupiah. And then after 6 months, you can get average by 6 tons of peanut from 1 hectare. 1 kilogram is 20,000 rupiah right now. So is will reach about 120 million rupiah. So the revenue is very high, and it will divide to the sponsor, to the operator, and to the hydro as a supervisor.
Now I'm in the wrong business, man. I gotta start growing some peanuts.
500 peanuts is coming up soon, Katie. Okay.
Yeah, that's it, man. That's it. Got it out of this durian business, takes too long. Hey, what is the URL? I just can't get the URL. iGrow.co.ie, is that it?
iGrow.asia.
.asia?
Yes.
Alright, thanks, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Alright, thanks guys. Thanks a lot. That's iGrow. You're on our boss. And now we're